Today we will learn about the antenna array. Antenna array is collection of multiple antenna element, or we can say it is a group of multiple antenna element. These element may be identical or it may be different. Most of the time we are preferring identical antenna element for simpler and convenient calculation purpose. What is the basic purpose behind creating the antenna array? Antenna array will provide the larger gain and narrow beam. So whenever we want to use antenna for longer distance communication with a narrow beam, we are having a two option. Either we can use the large height of the antenna, or we can use the antenna array. So antenna array will provide the larger gain and narrow beam. Now we are coming with the concept of antenna array. Two type of antenna array will be there. These may be linear array. If we are talking about the one dimensional antenna array, it may be a planar array if we are talking about the two dimensional antenna array. As the figure says, in case of the linear array, we are having all these element of antenna along the x-axis. It may be along the x-axis, or maybe along the y-axis, or maybe along the z-axis. But here all these antenna element are placed at x-axis, only one dimension, so this is known as the linear array. But in case of the planar array, we are having a antenna array along with a plane. So in this figure we are having a xy plane. In xy plane we are having a multiple antenna element, so this is known as the planar array. Now the concept is coming, how the antenna array will be formatted. So here we can observe that different type of antenna array which are practically used at for the various application purpose. And here we are having a formation of antenna array. In antenna array designing, we are using attenuator, phase shifter and antenna element. Each of the antenna element will provide electric field with some amplitude as well as some phase. So here we are having various antenna, starting from antenna number 1 to antenna number n, and we are having a different attenuator, different phase shifter and different antenna element at the transmitter side, and we are getting a field strength e1 e to the power j psi 1 from the antenna number 1, E2 e to the power j psi 2 from antenna number 2. Similarly, En e to the power j psi n from the antenna number n. This E1, E2, En, these are the magnitude of the electric field, and psi 1, psi 2, psi n, these are the different phase shift. Total field strength is given as E is equals to, it is a algebraic sum or summation of all these individual element field. So E1 e to the power j psi 1, E2 e to the power j psi 2 plus till En e to the power j psi n. Now we are getting a phase difference. Psi is given as beta d plus alpha. Alpha is the initial phase introduced by the phase shifter, and beta can be written as 2 pi by lambda, and d is the spacing between the multiple elements. Lambda is given as a wavelength, operating wavelength. Field magnitude of different antenna element is denoted by E1, E2, En, like that here. Now if we are talking about the array of two point source, so here we are deriving a mathematical expression how the radiation pattern will be generated if we are talking about the array of two point source. So first case we are considering here, these two point source with equal magnitude and phase of current supplied by the source A and source B. So in the figure we are having a two source A and B. These two point source is there and they are separated with the distance of D, and we have to calculate the field strength at the distance point P because of the presence of the source A as well as because of the presence of the source B. So first we are calculating how much phase difference is coming because of the source A and source B. So in between the A and B we are considering a reference point. This is 0, this is mid of the A and B. So here total distance is D. We are taking this distance is D by 2 and this distance is D by 2. And the point P is making an angle theta with reference to the reference point. So this theta is there. And now to calculate the how much phase difference or path difference is coming between source A and source B. So here we are having a perpendicular line from the B and this perpendicular line from the A. So that much path difference is coming between A and B, source A and source B. Source A is providing the lagging, but the source B is providing the leading if we are calculating the total field along the distance point P. And how much path difference is coming between A dash and B dash? This is D by 2 cos theta component and this is also D by 2 cos theta component. So total path difference A dash B dash is equals to D by 2 cos theta plus D by 2 cos theta, that is D cos theta. So here we are getting a path difference D cos theta. And phase difference, as we know that phase difference is beta times of path difference. So here beta is given as 2 pi by lambda and path difference is D cos theta. And initial phase introduced by the phase shifter, we are considering alpha, and this alpha value we are taking here 0. So psi is given as beta d cos theta. Now the total field is given at the distance point P. E is equals to E1 e to the power minus j psi by 2 plus E2 e to the power j psi by 2. These two fields are getting added because we are having a same phase. And same amplitude means E1 and E2 are also both are same. But here we are getting minus J psi by 2 and E to the power plus J psi by 2. Total phase difference is psi. At the source A and source B, we are having a phase difference of psi by 2. Psi by equal phase difference is coming. But at one side we are having a negative sign. At the other side we are having a positive sign because source A is providing the lagging phenomena, and here in the lagging case we are having a phase difference of pi by 2, but at the source B we are having a leading phenomena, and this leading is again with the same phase psi by 2. So because of these lagging and leading, we are having a positive and negative sign here. So total field strength is given by this formula. And as we are considering the case with equal magnitude, so E1 and E2 both are same, and that will be denoted by E0. When we are substituting these two values, E1 and E2 is equals to E, and after that we are getting total field E is equals to 2 E0 e to the power j psi by 2 plus e to the power j psi by 2 divided by 2. So we are taking a factor of 2 multiplication and 2 in the division, and this formula e to the power j theta plus e to the power minus j theta divided by 2 is considered as a cos theta. So here in place of theta we are having a psi by 2. So this value is coming E is equals to 2 E naught cos psi by 2. Now psi is the phase difference, so we can substitute this value of psi is equals to beta d cos theta, and beta is 2 pi by lambda, and here we are considering the d value is lambda by 2. So once we are substituting these two value, we are getting this formula is E is equals to En cos 2 pi by lambda, and in place of D we are substituting lambda by 2 cos theta divided by 2. So So now this value is coming. Electric field E is equals to En cos pi by 2 cos theta. En we are considering, En is a normalized value of the field that will be given as 2 times of E naught. And now if we are calculating the radiation pattern, in order to find out the radiation pattern, we require the maxima point where the maximum value of the field is coming, where the minimum point is coming, and what will be the half power point. So here in the expression, we are having a En cos pi by 2 cos theta. So to find out the maximum value of the field, we have to find out the maximum value of this cos function. And similarly, we have to find out the minimum value of this field. So minimum value of this cos function. So here we are calculating the maximum value. Cos pi by 2 cos theta is equals to maximum value will be plus minus 1 at the plus minus 1, because cos is lying between the plus minus 1 value. So this value is pi by 2 cos theta maximum is equals to plus minus n pi, and where n is the integer value, can we have the value of 0, 1, 2. So cos theta max is equals to plus minus 2n, and if we are substituting the value of n is equals to 0, because if n value will be greater, then this value is coming more than 2 or multiple of the 2. So here we are taking initial value n is equals to 0, cos theta will be 0 and theta will be 90 and 270. So here we are saying that maximum value of the radiation pattern is provided at the point of 90 degree and 270 degree. Similarly, for minimum point, we are considering this function value is equals to 0. So here theta minimum value is coming as 0 and 180 degree. And for half power point, we have to find out the where the power value is becoming half, and the voltage and current value is becoming 1 by root 2 times of the maximum value. So here we are taking cos 2 pi cos theta is equals to plus minus 1 by root 2. And for 1 by root 2, we are finding out the value. So theta half power HP, theta HP is equals to 60 degree and 120 degree. So now we are having a maxima point at 90 and 270, minima point or null point at 0 degree and 180, and half power point at 60 degree and 120 degree. So based on this calculation, if we are drawing the radiation pattern, this radiation pattern with reference to the theta, at theta is equals to 0, theta is equals to 90, theta is equals to 180, and theta is equals to 270. These two point sources A and B separated with the D, and D is given as lambda by 2. So we are finding out the radiation law, maximum value at corresponding to 90 degree and corresponding to 270 degree. And this is the 60 degree line and this is the 120 degree line. So at 60 and 120, we are having a half power point. So this will provide the half power beam width. And this antenna array is known as the broadside antenna array. And as we are considering the two point source, so that is known as the broadside couplet. Thank you.